The planned rationalization of the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, has stirred debate among members of the public, with many questioning government motives. But the government has remained steadfast on the move. It says it's aimed at reducing expenditure on common services and therefore saving costs and gaining efficiency. This week, the government chief whip, Honorable Dennis Hamson Noboa, alongside NRM legislators in parliament, came out to defend the government's position on rationalization of government agencies and public expenditures bill, insisting it has to be enacted. In a press conference held at Parliament on Wednesday, Oboa revealed that the Cabinet and the NRM caucus held four consecutive meetings in which a resolution was passed to support the rationalization of government agencies and public expenditure through the enactment of legislation in Parliament, sector by sector.
For the issue of coffee, we are going to mainstream the functions currently being exercised by UCDA under the Act into the mainstream Ministry of Agriculture by creating a department. The number one promoter of coffee is His Excellency the President General Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, and the same government that transitioned Coffee Marketing Board to UCDA is saying, at this point in time, we have taken a policy decision to either repeal, mainstream, or merge entities that we created.
Oboa affirmed that there is no rush by the government to pass the bill, adding that the decision to have the agencies rationalized was agreed upon in 2021 after conducting necessary consultation with stakeholders.
Somebody was asking, why the rush? There is no rush, because records available indicate that Cabinet approved the principles of rationalization in 2021.
During the press conference, some NRM MPs urged their counterparts to come out boldly and defend the position of the government on the rationalization of the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA.
We want to reduce service and functional duplication. We want to reduce that as a government. Three, high cost of administering these agencies.
They further warned against tribal sentiments being propagated by some politicians, which they say is diversionary.
Coffee is a strategic cash crop grown in all parts of Uganda. I have told you personally, I am a new coffee farmer. I would even be more worried than them. But I am not worried, because my coffee in the garden will be there. UCDA is an agency of government of Uganda represented by the Ministry of Agriculture.
For us to support the issue of rationalization, there is no amount of intimidation that is going to divert. We are going to look at issues of numbers in the House. And when the majority votes and says yes, we are going to pass it.
The government has further warned against politicizing the rationalization debate and skewing it along tribal lines. The Minister of Lands, Housing and Urban Development, Judith Nabakoba, earlier this week retaliated the government's position to have UCDA merged with its mother ministry of MAAIF.
Government decided to rationalize some of those agencies, to take them to their mother ministries. It's not that government is going to disband the technical people. It's the agencies that are disbanded. Then the technical people are going to return to their mother ministries, and they will continue to do the services they have been offering to the Ugandans. What has been missing is explanation. We are all farmers. We are all farmers, but when rationalization came, it came because government wanted to reduce on the costs they are spending on these agencies. And that's why they decided that UNRWA should be rationalized, NITAU, Me, I had the National Physical Planning Board. It was already rationalized long time ago. The law was even signed by His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda, and that is the spirit.
During his address to the Parliamentary Caucus of the National Resistance Movement, NRM, at the State House in Entebbe on Friday, 6th of September 2024, President Yoweri Museveni and NRM Caucus members agreed on the merger and rationalization of government agencies as the fundamental strategy for optimal resource allocation.